Ashish Choudhury from IIT Hyderabad. So I did my graduation in architecture and I am really fresh in the field of design. So in this semester we were told to go to Osmania Hospital, that is a government hospital in Hyderabad, and we were told to map problems in a hospital. So what I proposed as a solution, in this presentation I just have an idea, I don't have a product. So my idea was to incubate smartness in medical field, or to bring medical e-governance. E-governance is governance that includes ICT, and the need of medical e-governance calls when as we noticed in government hospital that mostly the user in a government hospital is the class that is lower class. Why don't we middle class or the people from upper class go to government hospital? Because facilities are not good and the it's corrupt. So the methodology of to find an idea was to map the problem, to do problem analysis, identifying stakeholders, identifying available resources, and then synthesize the problem and to come up with product or the idea of the product. So what we noticed is in OPD the main problem was long queue and the lack of information. Like my classmate came up with a signage system for a hospital. So for that, and in the department with long term diagnosis, the main problem was the data handling. And in medication, there was we observed a lack of regulation, availability of the medicines, overdose by the patient. And in case of labor and childbirth, the lack of communication, or majorly availability of the ambulance. And in the case of emergency and accidents, again the lack of communication and the unavailability of ambulance. So the idea that we proposed was to we mapped stakeholders in a hospital are mainly patients, doctors, hospital authorities, ambulance drivers and chemists. And the resources that we had were Aadhaar, the web portal that we can design, the Android or the iOS, GPS and GIS. The main difference between GPS and GIS is GPS is to locate moving objects or the real-time position of a person in a vehicle or something, and GIS is the database of locations that are stationary. So how I propose the system will work is the most basic and important thing was the registration process. So every hospital, every chemist, every doctor and every ambulance driver will have to register in the web portal, and every citizen or let us call them patient will have to register in the web portal. And the information that is to be provided by the citizen is name, his permanent address, phone number, email address, Aadhaar detail for individuality of the patient, and obviously security reasons, medical reports, medical history. So in parallel, every doctor of the government hospital or even private hospital will have to register with his name, his specialization, hospital and clinics is associated with, experience, registration detail with the MCI, that is Medical Council of India, permanent address, phone number, email, and again Aadhaar details. Similarly, hospital will have to register with details, name, specialities, or the facilities that hospital is offering, doctors and specialists associated with the particular hospital, location, permanent address, phone number. Again, ambulance driver will have to register, and the chemist will have to register with the medical stock that is available with him, the rate list of all medicines. This is because the issue of generic medicines with generic name and phone number and email. So in case of OPD, how the system will work, first the patient will have to do the registration, and as he goes to doctor, the doctor with login from his account and sees the medical history of patient, that is what he feed into the system earlier, and the doctor will diagnose and prescribe the medication that will be linked to the Aadhaar number of the citizen. So that is by that the patient will have we will have our data will have a data, the system, the online system will have data of the patient, what is his or her medical history, and what medicines are prescribed by the doctor, and where he or she can find the medicine with the generic name in the cheapest with the cheapest rate. So in the same manner, the labor and the childbirth will work. In the case of road accident, the person who is injured or someone else can just click a button on the app that is for the for the whole smart city, and the ambulance driver can track the GPS detail of the injured person and can go directly to the location of the accident and get the victim and get him to the hospital that is nearest to the location. So this is how all system will work. So for the idea, the SWOT analysis that it did is strength. The system will have is authentic medication, no drug fraud, no overdose. The weakness is it is not really vital for the emergency.
You were showing some flows on how a patient. Yes, those. Can you go one up? One more. Right here. Have you witnessed this, or is this research from desktop, or did you spend time in a hospital?
Sir, I spent time in hospital. I did some research, and I wrote a research paper on this. And now I'm working on the product itself. So I'm in first semester of design. I did it whole last month. It was our design project. We are basically learning in our first semester graphic design. So I did graphic designing as the submission for this problem. But again, in fourth semester, we have to submit a product or a thesis. So I've started working on this product. So this is in research phase. So this is all my idea, sir.
Okay.
So if I'm understanding correctly, you have one, basically a data lake of information, and it's a secure data lake, and you're turning on and off access to that information based on when they need it. Is that correct?
Not exactly when they need it. Like if I'm a doctor, so I'll have to keep my account logged in as every patient is coming. But if I'm a patient, then obviously I'll log in or log out from the system when I'm going to the doctor. And as a chemist, I'll have to keep logged in every time. But if there's a lady who is expecting and is in her last trimester, so she and her family members will have to be active on the system. So that's the need.
So we see that your assumptions are that this is for a public hospital, right? Keeping in mind that public hospitals are not being looked at effective centers for diagnosis and usage. So my question is that there is a large population in India who can't really afford basic medical health facilities. So in such a situation, how do you plan to monetize this? There could be private companies that are doing this, but on a based on a fee per year. So what is your proposition of how this could be made available to a larger section of the audience in India?
So so I'm proposing this system for a smart city. So it's not necessary to have only government hospitals or public hospitals as part of this system. Suppose if this is a system for whole city, so every hospital, every government hospital, every private hospital can be a part of the system, so that there is a strong governance. Like if I'm an individual and I don't have a mobile, but still I'll have an Aadhaar number, so at least doctor can see my medical history using the Aadhaar number or my unique ID. Even if I don't have a mobile or I don't have a connection to internet, so the doctor, at least doctor, chemist, or the other elements of the system can see my medical history.